Oh, hi there! It's so good to see you. You're just in time. Why don't you sign in first? If you have already, just pick your name from the list.
Welcome to the Blue House.
Hello from the Small Mouse.
Things to do.
Fun for you.
Howdy from the Big Bear. Want some fun?
Here's where.
Just for you.
All is new.
In the House of Blue. Lots of room at our house.
Catch the moon at our house.
Kitchen's here.
Bathroom's there.
Attic full of stuff here.
Pillows full of fluff here.
Just for you.
In the House of Blue.
Oh! Hi there! Wait a minute. What's that smell? Smells like... Ooh, berries! It's you! Ooh, have you been walking through a field? Because you smell just like freshly picked berries. I love that smell. It reminds me of triple berry pie. Or maybe you smell this good all the time. Well, come on in. Speaking of triple berry pie...
Did we hear someone say triple berry pie?
Triple berry pie
is delicious.
We love triple berry pie.
I love the way triple berry pie feels all warm and crunchy in my mouth.
And triple berry pie looks so great. Almost as great as cheese. Almost.
Triple berry pie.
We know what foods we like by the way they taste. We know our friends by sight and by hearing their voices. When we smell or touch a flower, we can tell how beautiful it is. The five senses of taste, sight, hearing, smell, and touch are how we discover things about ourselves and our world.
I've got my eyes to look around, a tongue to taste my meal, a nose for smell and ears for sound, a body that can feel. I've got five senses to bring me the world, so it makes sense to me. I've got five senses and a world I love, to hear and smell and feel and taste and see. It's great to smell a berry pie and feel that crunchy crust. I hear the door, I see that you've stopped by. You wanna taste, you must. 'Cause you've got five senses to take it all in, whatever it might be. You've got five senses and one big world, to hear and smell and feel and taste and see. Whoa! To hear and smell and feel and taste and see.
Yep, there's nothing better for the senses than triple berry pie. Hey, would you like to make some together?
Hey there!
Oh, and you too!
Come with us to make Pip
and Pop's
famous clam dip!
It tastes delicious!
I'm going to build a house for Snowbear as a surprise. Do you want to help me?
Yeah, you too! Come on!
What do you want to do? Hey, have you been to a horse race? Their hooves pound the ground as they run. Yee-haw! It's great to have a nice coat, or a fur coat if you're a bear, to keep you nice and warm on a cold day.
All right, to the kitchen!
Wonderful, I'm hungry too.
Pip and Pop love clam dip because they like the way it tastes on their tongues. That's what you use to taste with, your tongue. But you probably already knew that. I wonder what tasty treats Pip and Pop will put in the bowl to make their famous clam dip. I can't wait to taste Pip and Pop's famous clam dip. So, what are you going to put in it?
Oh, things everybody likes to make the best clam dip ever!
Yes, sir. Something sweet.
Something salty.
And of course, no clam dip would be complete without
something sour.
Wow, you sure thought of a lot of different tastes.
Yeah, but Bear...
We have a problem.
Yeah, we don't know what will make it
sweet
or salty or
sour.
Let's see. Well, green apples are sour, so is a lemon and a white grapefruit.
Boy, those really are sour, Bear.
Hey, could you choose one for us?
Whoa! Get ready to pucker up, Pop!
Mm-hmm. Now, what tastes sweet? Cupcakes, or cookies, or maybe even a chocolate cake.
Whoa, those all sound good, Bear.
What do you think?
When I think of salty, I think of things like potato chips, or pretzels, or crackers.
Whoa, yeah! Wow. They're as salty as,
clam at the bottom of the sea!
You did a good job picking things for Pip and Pop.
Yeah! Now we know what to put in our clam dip.
Definitely. Yeah. But Bear! We have another problem!
Yeah, we don't know where to find them!
Hey, why don't you help Pip and Pop find what they need? You just picked up some big blue house berries. We call them that because they're blue and are as big as a house. Okay, maybe not that big, but they sure taste like it. We'll need 6 bunches of berries for the pie. Look out for them. Luna red berries only grow when there's a full moon, but you can eat them anytime.
Don't tell Pip you saw me!
Hey, let's see what smells so good. Come on! Just pick a path and we'll sniff out clues together. I'll let you know if we're on the right path. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. What's that smell? Hey! Great! Let's go left!
Achoo!
Some smells tickle my nose, but that's not our smell. Let's go right. Let's go right. Hey! What's that smell? It smells like syrup. Maple syrup. Want to borrow my nose? For another scent search? Let's go right. Hey, what's that smell? Hey. Great, let's go left. Great, let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. It smells fruity. Maybe it's something tasty and yummy. Apples! What's your favorite kind of apple? Red and sweet or green and sour? Want to borrow my nose for another scent search?
Great! Let's go left. Okay, let's go right. Okay, we'll go straight ahead.
Ew, smelly! Someone must have left out some sour milk.
Great, let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Great, let's go left. Sure, let's go back.
Uh-oh.
Let's go right. Let's go right.
Phew! Hold your nose.
Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Let's go right. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Let's go right. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Let's go right. Let's go right. Great! Let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Great! Let's go left. Great! Let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead.
Maple syrup. Mm-hmm. Want to borrow mine?
Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Hey, hey. Let's go right. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Great, let's go left. Great, let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. What's that smell? It smells like a springtime garden.
It's a rose. Ah, I just love roses. Want to buy?
Great, let's go left.
Hey.
Hey. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Let's go right. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Let's go right. Let's go right.
Hey, what's that smell? It smells all warm and buttery, like a bakery. Ah, fresh bread. Mmm! Makes me want to make sandwiches with lots of butter and honey. Want to borrow my nose for another scent search? That's a Oh, that was close, but it still didn't come down. One more
You did it!
Yeah, now we have something sour
for Pip
and Pop's
famous
clam dip.
Big, plump, juicy berries taste so good, especially in my famous triple berry pancakes, and of course my triple berry pie. My bee friends stay busy making lots of honey for this bear to eat. Just picked up some big blue house berries. We call them that because they're blue and are as big as a house. Wow, you've just found some very rare green pond berries. They're rare because Pip and Pop usually eat them before anyone else can find them. Hey, looks like we can make something sweet. There's some batter and some pans. Yep, that's the pan Pip and Pop need. Let's bake it!
Great baking!
Oh, thank you so very much!
Now we have something sweet for Pip and Pop's famous clam dip! Mm-hmm.
Whoa! From up here, I'm higher than... Where's Tutter?
Yeah, he's always up for a salty snack.
I wonder why this trail of cracker crumbs is heading right for Tutter's mouse hole. Tutter, by any chance, have you seen a salty snack of mine around here?
Oh, you're looking for these crackers, Bear? Oh, no problem! I was just using them as, bookends. That's it. Alright! You found something salty!
Thank you!
This dip is gonna be the best ever!
Well, you found something salty, something sweet, and something sour for Pip and Pop. Now it's time to make Pip and Pop's famous clam dip. Come on! Pip and Pop will give you directions on how to make their special dip.
First, something sour.
That adds power!
Yeah, what do you think, Pip? Rhymes pretty good.
Well, you know you did what you could.
I think Pip and Pop asked for something else.
Put in a tomato.
It's better than a potato.
Chili peppers will give it some spice.
Yes, sir, Pop, that'll be so nice. Something sweet
would be really neat.
Put the onion on top.
It'll give it some pop. And Pip. Put the salty thing in the bowl.
Remember, you found it in Tutter's hole.
Cream cheese will make it thick.
Oh, I cannot wait to take a lick.
Okay, looks like the dip is done.
But Bear, you forgot
the most important ingredient,
the clams.
Whoops, you're right. Add each clam.
And our dip
will be a grand slam.
Now mash it all up with the big fork. Pip and Pop's famous clam dip is done. Let's have them taste it and tell us what they think.
I like the salty taste, but yeah, I don't like the sweet taste.
Interesting, because you see, I like the sweet taste, but I do not like the salty taste.
We don't like the sour taste.
That's too bad. What do you think will make it better?
Well, the next time that we make Pip
and Pop's famous clam dip,
we will only put in what we both like.
Yeah, when it's done, I'll add something salty to my bowl.
And I will add something sweet to mine. Yum!
Wow, Pip and Pop found they have different tastes. You've got taste too. Mm-hmm. Just try new foods and discover a great taste you've never tasted before. Hey! Take a look in here. This is a book about the fun you had with Pip and Pop. We'll call it Dip Time. Pip and Pop needed ingredients for their clam dip. You baked up a sweet treat to add to the dip. The sour fruit was high in a tree, but you got it down. A crumb trail led to Tutter's mouse hole and a salty snack. Pip and Pop learned not everyone likes to eat the same things. I put all the storybooks of your adventures in the big blue house right here on my bookshelf. Whenever you want to open one, just come on over and pick it out. Aha! Oh, you're back!
Look what I found. Pie dough for triple berry pie. Mm-hmm. Hey, do you think you could hold on to it? For me? Great! Now let's find the rest of the stuff we need for the pie. If you want to, you can join me and we'll find the things to make triple berry pie.
We'll build Snowbear's house with hard things and soft things and warm things and all kinds of other things too. Let's go!
Treelo wants to listen to favorite song. You want to hear too?
I'm going to redecorate my mouse hole and make it more beautiful than ever. You can come too. Come on.
So, what do you want to do?
Oh, good. Let's go to the living room.
Look at all the neat things Ojo has collected for Snowbear's house. Different shapes and sizes and all kinds of textures. Do you know what a texture is? It's what something feels like when you touch it. Think about what all those things would feel like in your hands. So Ojo, what do you need for Snowbear's house?
All kinds of things, Bear, and I haven't found them all. I need walls, I need a roof, and I need a doormat too. I have so much stuff to find, and I don't know what to use.
Well, for the walls, you'll probably want to use something hard. What can we find around the house? Maybe pennies, or shells, or wood sticks. Which would you use?
Good choice! Thanks!
Now, for the roof. Some folks make roofs out of clay. Some use mud, and some even use tar. What's best?
Hey, yeah! That will feel soft and mushy when you first touch it. But then when it will dry, it will be good and hard.
Now, no house is complete without a doormat. Snowbear needs something rough, so when she gets visitors, they can scrape their dirt off their feet. How about a nail file, or sandpaper, or a dish pad?
Yeah, those are all perfect for Snowbear's house.
Good job! You know your textures.
Uh-huh. But where do I find all those things? Will you help me?
Ooh, you're good at finding things. Where do you think we should start?
Pip is looking for me. Don't tell him I'm here. It'll be our secret.
Luna Redberry's all.
I love stories. That's why I have all these books. Do you have a favorite book?
Onion, potato chips. Chili peppers, potato chips. Potato chips. You are just so clever to make that match. Cupcake. Onion. It's a match. You are very good at this. Chili peppers. It's a match. You are very good at this.
Pop?
Yeah,
Pip? Is that a match?
Yep, that's a match.
Good job!
Cupcake. Cupcake! Cupcake, it's a match! You are very good at this!
In case you did not know,
there is no ham in a hamburger.
No dog in a hot dog.
And no peas in peanut butter!
Garlic!
Hey, I got an idea, Pop!
What, Pip?
Let's match things that kinda, you know, taste like each other.
Oh! I get it! Like, lemon.
And, grapefruit.
Ooh! They're both sour!
Hard candy. Coconut. Pretzel. Hot sauce. Coffee beans. Cupcake. Potato chips. Pepperoni pizza. Cupcake. Pepperoni pizza. Hard candy. Cupcake. Those two are sweet. Coconut. Potato chips. Coffee beans. Coconut. Ew! That's what I call bitter. Yuck! Pretzel. Potato chips. Those are both so salty that just looking at them makes me thirsty.
I match you.
You match me.
That's because we're family.
Hot sauce. Pepperoni pizza hot sauce. Those two are spicy.
This is fun.
Hey, let's do it again.
Potato ground pepper. Chili peppers. Ground pepper. That's really spicy. Coffee beans. Sugar. Hard candy. Sugar. Ha! Those two are so sweet together. Coconut. Pretzel. Potato chips. Pretzel. Those are both so salty that just looking at them makes me thirsty.
Oh, hey, Pip!
Yeah, Pop?
Now, let's match things that are both made from the same food.
Oh, yeah, like french fries?
Oh, and, potato salad. Mm. They're both made with potatoes!
Relish. Applesauce. Strawberry shortcake. Applesauce. Relish. Strawberry shortcake. Applesauce. Strawberry shortcake. Pickle. Relish. Relish comes from chopped up pickles. French fries. Apple pie. Strawberry applesauce. Apple pie. Applesauce. If you picked some apples from an apple tree, you can make these. Potato jam. Strawberry jam. Strawberry shortcake. Strawberry jam. You can tell just from the name that they both have strawberries.
I match you.
You match me.
That's because we're family.
Potato chips. French fries. Potato chips. Did you know both were made from potatoes?
Hey, Pop, do you know how to make a banana split?
No. How?
Give it some legs!
Legs, because it leaves.
Yeah, you get that.
Potato chip. Block of cheese. French fries. Potato chips. Did you know both were made from potatoes? Relish. Macaroni and cheese. Pickle. Relish. Relish comes from chopped up pickles. Apple pie. Applesauce. If you picked some apples from an apple tree, you can make these. Block of cheese. Macaroni and cheese block of cheese. Their names tell you why these are a match.
Wow, you did so well!
You got that right, Pip.
Yeah.
Let's play again!
Cookies, relish. Strawberry jam, applesauce. Strawberry short applesauce. Strawberry shortcake. You can tell just from the name that they both have strawberries. Brownies. Cookies. One word matches these up. Chocolate.
Oh, great gobs of Gouda! My cheese cellar is completely dark! Can you help me get a snack? I've got the light. You give me the right directions, and the cheese will be ours! Hey, do you see those spots over there? You know, those glowy bright spots? Well, those are light switches, and if you turn them on, we'll see better. Hey, I can see! Oh, I think that light's going to make our cheese adventure much easier. But come on! Oh, did you see what I did there? Amazing! Cheese prize is ours! Eureka! Oh, great gobs of Gouda! My golden friend! Try some? Come on! I smell more cheese! Hungry Mouse coming through! Don't forget to turn on the glowy spots so we can see! Thanks! Hey, I can see! Oh, I think this... Hey, oh, my breathe! Oh, my little Gouda! I'm a-coming! I can see! Oh, it all looks marvelous! Cheese prize is ours! Eureka! You know, I just love a nice mild Monterey Jack melted on my bread! All that bubbly, cheesy goodness! Oh, give it a try! Come on! I smell more cheese! Hungry Mouse coming through! Don't forget to turn on the glowy spots so we can see! This maze is amazing! Almost there! A delectable crumb of cheese prize is ours! Eureka! Look! It's snowing Parmesan cheese! Oh, open your mouth and catch a flake! Come on! I smell more cheese! Hungry Mouse coming through! Don't forget to turn on the glowy spots so we can see! A delectable crumb of cheese! Thanks! It's much easier to see! Hey, I can see! Whoa, I think that light's going to make our cheese adventure much easier! Oh, come on! This maze is... That's it! This maze is amazing! I can see! Yes! My cheese! Let me at him! Ah, beautiful soft white brie! Do you want some? Come on! I smell more cheese! Hungry Mouse coming through! Don't forget to turn on the glowy spots so we can see! This maze... Hey, I can see! Whoa, I think that light's going to make our cheese... I can see! Oh, it all looks marvelous! This maze is amazing! Oh, did you see what I did there? Amazing! Oh, I can taste that cheese now! I'm a-coming! Flip the mouse to get me moving! Whoa, wait! I don't mean me! I mean the computer mouse! Yes! My cheese! Let me at him! Look! It's snowing Parmesan cheese! Oh! Open your mouth and catch a flake!
on! I smell more cheese! Hungry Mouse coming through! Don't forget to turn on the glowy spots so we can see!
You found the tar! But we need a shovel and pail to collect it. There's one somewhere in the house.
An umbrella keeps my fur nice and dry when I go out in the rain. Use one and you'll stay dry too. That's my hat box. I'll bet you can figure out what goes inside it without even looking.
You have two bunches of those berries already. You have two bunches of those berries already. Wow! You've just found some very rare green pond berries. They're rare because Pip and Pop usually eat them before anyone else can find them. Good job! You've collected all the berries we need to make a delicious triple berry pie. Mmm! I can taste it now!
I use this barrel to keep things in, like apples, water, and seeds. But sometimes, they're good for drumming, too.
Don't tell Pip you saw me!
Scales weigh things, like big old bears. Hey, how much do you weigh, Oh, you can look through the glass of the door, but don't forget it's there, or you might walk through it and hurt yourself. Scales weigh. This bear loves to soak in a nice warm bubble bath. How about you?
That'll hold enough tar for Snowbear's roof. Let's put it in your basket. You have two bunches of those berries already. There should be sandpaper in there somewhere, but it's so dark, you'll have to feel for it. That looks like what we want.
All right, you found a doormat.
After a nice warm bath, I like to get my fur nice and dry with a big, fluffy, clean towel. The toilet. It makes the funniest sound when you flush.
Ojo loves to cuddle with her soft and furry friend, Snowbear. I bet you have something special you like to cuddle with. What does it feel like?
Stuffed animals are so cuddly and soft, it feels good to hug one. Do you have a favorite stuffed animal?
By changing the top, middle, and the bottom of each toy, you can make new toys and new sounds. That horn will come in handy if the horse gets in a traffic jam. A drum. Treelo sounded like a siren. I hear a busy bee. Cow aboard! I think your pig is ringing. Did you hear a car drive by? Doesn't Treelo do great sound imitations? Trumpet! Just like a bird flapping her wings. I wonder what's in these jars. They're so dusty. Good idea! That rag can dust the jars. That looks like what we want.
Oh, that's great. You found something hard to build some walls. Thanks.
A shovel and pail will work just great here. We found the tar. The pail is all filled up.
Hey, Neat! This will make a really great roof for Snowbear's new house.
Good going! You found everything Ojo needs. You'll be able to build a really strong house, one that's warm and cozy.
Let's start with the walls. Add the wood sticks to make it really hard. Ooh, those walls look really, really strong. Thanks. Now, cover the roof with tar. Ooh, look at how strong the house is. Cool. Now let's do the furniture. The little pillow will make a soft bed for Snowbear. She likes her. That silky scarf can be her blanket. She likes things that feel silky. This is Snowbear's hairbrush. She likes the way it smooths her fur when I brush her. We can use that spool of thread for a table. The doormat is rough. That way it picks up dirt on someone's feet, and the dirt won't get into the house. Ooh, the house is almost perfect. Oh, wait a minute. Just one more thing.
The doormat says, "Welcome to all Snowbear's friends. You did such a great job on Snowbear's house. It's the bestest house she's ever had."
Some houses are made of bricks, or logs, or even grass. And an Eskimo's house is called an igloo, and it's made of ice. Then there's the big blue house. The perfect house for a bear and his friends.
Snowbear's got the best house of all because her house was made by her friends, like you. I can't wait to show it to her. She's going to love it, really. Bye, Bear.
Oh, bye, Ojo. You had some very good ideas to help Ojo. What kind of place do you live in? Is it made of wood or steel? Is it one floor or two? Is it an apartment, a house, or an igloo? Hey! I have something for you.
Here's a storybook about your adventure with Ojo. We'll call it Great Builder. Ojo asked you to help her build Snowbear's house. The jars in the attic had something hard for the walls. You found something mushy in the otter pond to put on the roof. There is something rough from the bathroom that we used as a doormat. You helped Ojo make a terrific house for Snowbear.
Hey, it's you again. Guess what I found? A pie cutter. You know, I bet Ojo was going to use it for Snow Bear's house. Lucky for me, she changed her mind. Why don't you hold on to it? Good. Now about that pie. If you want to, you can join me and we'll find the things to make triple berry pie.
Treelo wants to listen to favorite song. You want to hear too?
I'm going to redecorate my mouse hole and make it more beautiful than ever. You can come too. Come on.
So, what do you want to do?
Wah! To the bedroom. Listen to Treelo's favorite song.
Treelo loves music. In fact, he loves all sounds. He has very sensitive ears. Some people can hear a pin drop. Treelo can hear it while it's falling.
A tape recorder can play so many sounds. sounds we hear every day.
So Treelo, will you play us your tape?
Yeah, Treelo's favorite song.
Treelo's gonna play us his favorite song. That's too bad, Treelo. I know that was your favorite tape, but, you know, there are other ways to make music. In fact, you can make music with things from around the house. Well, hey, why don't you pick some things for Treelo to make music with? First, we need something to keep the beat, like, a tin can, a glass, or a pot. Which one do you like best?
You have! You have Treelo!
Yeah. And for an instrument, how about a flute? Or a guitar? Or a trumpet? Now, what do we have around the house that sings? A rubber duck? A rubber frog? Or a rubber cat? Good thinking! I mean, listening! Treelo's gonna make some great music! I think Treelo could use your help finding the music items and making a song.
I know!
And I know!
Where the musical instrument is!
And we'll tell you!
When you win, Pop Says!
It's a game!
See, we name something
for you to pick up.
But you only get it
when we say,
Pop Says!
Yeah, if we don't say,
Pop Says,
do not pick it up.
When you get it right,
well, 5 times in a row,
we'll tell you
where the musical instrument is. Ha! Let's play!
Pop Says, click on
a box of crayons.
4 more to go.
Click on
a book.
Three more.
Pop Says, click on
a piggy bank.
Only 2 more.
Pop Says, click on
a car.
Just 1 more.
Pop Says, click on
a teddy bear.
Pop Says!
Those are our toys, but they're floating upside down.
Huh? Do you hear that? I wonder where it's coming from.
I wonder what's going on in there. Listen closely and tap the same thing back.
Hello, hello! Who is it?
It's Bear and a friend.
Well, why didn't you say so, Bear? Boy, you sure are good at knocking out a beat. Do you want to borrow my homemade drum?
Now it's time to make some music. Let's make a song for Treelo. I'll start humming, and you add sounds by choosing any item you found. Hey, you're a great musician. Let's listen to the music you made. If you want to play your song for Treelo, click on the green button.
Making music fun! Woohoo! Treelo dance! Treelo go now! Bye!
Oh, bye Treelo! Isn't it amazing how you can find music everywhere? In the pond, in the living room, even here in the bedroom. Hey! Maybe this will help you make music on your own.
This is the story of your adventure with Treelo. It's called Treelo's Song. Treelo needed help to make his own music. You discovered a squeaky toy for him in the bathtub.
It was awfully nice of Tutter to lend us his drum.
You played the game with Pip and Pop so well that you found a musical instrument. Treelo jumped up and danced when he heard the music we made together.
Hey, there you are! Look what I found. It's a rolling pin. We could use it to make music. But, you know what it works best for? Making triple berry pie! Hey, let's put it in your basket. All right, the pie adventure continues! If you want to, you can join me and we'll find the things to make triple berry pie.
I'm going to redecorate my mouse hole and make it more beautiful than ever. Ha, you can come too. Come on.
So.
Excellent choice. To the mouse hole. Let's go. Okay. That's close enough.
What's going on, Tutter?
Sorry, Bear. You can't see inside until all the redecorating work is done. Could you excuse me for just a moment?
Sounds like Tutter is giving his mouse hole a whole new look. Redecorating is exciting. He'll have new colors and lights and fun things all over. So, Tutter, how are you going to redecorate your mouse hole?
I told you, Bear, it's a surprise, a surprise! But I could use a little help. This place needs a paint job, a picture on the wall, and something to light everything up.
Let's see. Paint. You could have a lot of different colors, like orange, green, or purple. What do you like?
one.
And you said a picture? How about a picture of a bear? Bears are quite handsome, don't you think? Or a picture of cheese, your favorite food. You can even have a picture of the mouse hole, the place you like best of all.
Oh, great Gouda. There's so many choices, Bear. So many. Hey, what do you think?
And now for the lighting. Different kinds of light will make the mouse hole look different. Like a chandelier, or a disco ball, or maybe even a lava lamp. Thanks, you've made some great suggestions. Well, good luck, Tutter.
What, hold on! Oh, I can't possibly find all this stuff by myself, Bear. I don't have time, no time.
Well, hey, maybe our friend can help you, Tutter. Can you find what Tutter needs? All right, now you can take a picture.
I love that picture! Boy, you're a great photographer. I'm taking it right inside.
Turning the dials on the lock will reveal different colors. Click on one and see.
My light! You found the perfect light for my mouse hole!
Show you something. See? It's a globe of the world. I've been thinking about all the places you can live and all the things you can be.
That sounds like a good game of pretend, Dojo.
Hey, yeah, Bear. I love to pretend. Do you? Okay, come on. We can pretend to be anything and go anywhere we want to. We're world explorers!
All right. I can see it now.
Let's be dogs, okay?
I wonder what it feels like to be a dog with fur.
Oh, or we could pretend we're a dog with scales. Or even feathers.
Can you imagine what a dog with scales would feel like? What do you think? What kind of dog would you want to be?
A dog with scales. We'll feel very bumpy.
I can see it now. You could live underwater and be great swimmers and swim to Ojo Island.
Ooh, we're wet all over. Pip and Pop would like this pretend. Ooh, I love to swim. But I love to do other things too. Like, be an acrobat.
If you're going to do flips like an acrobat, you'll need someplace soft to land in, like sand.
Ooh, or maybe we'd rather flip on the grass, or even on a pile of seaweed. So, where would you like to play? Yeah, because if we fall on the sand, at least it will be soft. Gee, this is fun! Oh, but hey, you look like you have to stop.
You do? Why?
Bear? It looks like someone has an itchy back.
Well, that sounds like a problem for a bear. You need something to scratch it on, like underwater coral.
Or we could scratch an itch with
an anchor, or even an oyster shell.
Hmm, what do you want to scratch that itch with? Ooh, an anchor. You could scratch your itch on the hard edge.
That's better. Now it's time to flip and roll and be happy.
Happiness is a feeling too.
Hey, do you want to play pretend with me again? All you have to do is click on the globe.
Yeah, Ojo, I can see it now. Like, if you were a fish.
Hey, yeah, come on, let's pretend we're fish.
Okay, what kind of fish do you want to be this time?
We could have fur, or feathers, or scales.
What do you think? I wonder what it feels like to be a fish with fur. What do you think? What kind of fish would you be?
I'd be a furry fish. We'd be all fluffy and cuddly.
You'd make a good pet, I bet.
We'd live in a nice, cozy house. But on a cold day, we would have to find some way to get warm.
A fire would be nice, but don't get too close.
Hey, Bear! We could get warm by flying in the sunshine or, chasing a ball.
What would you do to get warm if you were cold? Running and having fun is a great way to warm up.
Gee, you look kind of hot. You're sweating.
This sounds like a good time for a fan to cool you off.
Would you like a cold drink? Or maybe a swim in the pond?
What do you like to do to cool down when you're hot? I love taking a dip in some water when I'm hot, but never go in alone.
Now we feel happy. Not too cold and not too hot. Hey, do you want to play
Great idea, Ojo. I can see it now. You could fly to faraway places if...
We're birds. Let's be birds.
That's a bird. What kind do you want to be?
We could have fur, or feathers, or scales.
I wonder how it would feel to be a bird with fur. Soft? Warm? What do you think? What sort of bird do you want to be?
Oh, a bird with feathers. We'd be soft as silk.
Wow, you could fly high in the sky with feathers.
Ooh, can you feel the wind under your wings? Ooh, Bear, we've been flying so long, we're getting kind of tired.
A rest sounds like a good idea. How about someplace like a rock?
Oh, hey, or we could rest in a tree, or maybe on top of a house. Where should we rest?
A rock is a good, sturdy resting spot, especially because it doesn't move.
These resting places, they all feel kind of hard, Bear. We want a nice, soft spot so we can go to sleep.
Like a haystack.
Or maybe a pillow. Or even the belly of a bear. Where do you want to go to sleep? A bear's belly feels so furry and warm. That's my favorite place to take a nap. Sleepy time. Now we're comfy and happy and ready to go right to sleep. Hey!
Yeah, Ojo, I can see it now. Like, if you were a fish.
Hey, yeah, come on, let's pretend we're fish.
Okay, what kind of fish do you want to be this time?
We could have fur, or feathers, or scales.
What do you think it would feel like to be a fish with feathers? What do you think? What kind of fish would you be?
That's funny. A fish with feathers. That would make us soft and light.
Wow, you could fly high in the sky with feathers.
Ooh, can you feel the wind under your wings? Ooh, Bear, we've been flying so long, we're getting kind of tired.
A rest sounds like a good idea. How about someplace like a rock?
Oh, hey! Or we could rest in a tree, or maybe on top of a house. Where should we rest?
A house makes a good resting place. Up high where you and Ojo can feel the warm sunshine.
These resting places, they all feel kind of hard, Bear.
We want a nice soft spot so we can go to sleep.
Like a haystack.
Or maybe a pillow. Or even the belly of a bear. Where do you want to go to sleep? Oh, great! A big fluffy pile of hay. That's the perfect place to rest and nap. Sleepy time. Now we're comfy and happy and ready to go right to sleep. Hey, do you want to play pretend with me again? All you have to do is click on the globe. Bye! Come back and we'll play pretend again. We can play it anytime you want to.
See? It's a globe of the world! I've been thinking about all the places you can live and all the things you can be.
That sounds like a good game of pretend, Ojo.
Hey, yeah, Bear! I love to pretend! Do you? Okay, come on! We can pretend to be anything and go anywhere we want to. We're world explorers!
Great idea!
Bye! Come back and we'll play pretend again. We can play it anytime you want to.
It's a paint set. You know, you can mix together colors to make new ones. I bet you can make the color for Tutter's walls. Try adding two colors to an empty dish. You need to add two different colors to make a grate. That matches the color we need for Tutter's walls.
Oh yeah, that's the perfect color! Just perfect! I'm taking it back to my mouse hole right away! Let's go!
Redecorating is so much fun! You can help Tutter fix up his mouse hole.
Aw, thank you, friend! Boy, you're really helping me out here! If you paint the wall, hang up the picture, and put the light in place, I'll show you my completely redecorated mouse hole! Excuse me! I think maybe you should paint the wall first. You know, paint first, hang later. The best spot for the picture would be, let's see. Oh, I know! The center of the wall! Oh, yeah! Yes! Perfect! Picture perfect! Oh, picture perfect! Oh, my sides! Now, put the light on the table. Oh, just great! Okay, now close your eyes. Well, Bea, you close your eyes too. And I'll turn out the old lights and turn on the new ones! Ta-da! Look at my house! Look at my house! It's wonderful! Boy, I feel like a brand new mouse!
Very interesting, Tutter. Everything really glows.
Well, I gotta go. Thanks for stopping by, Bear. Now that my mouse hole is all fixed up, I am going to stay in it forever! That's right! It's so perfect that I'm never going to have to leave it again! Well, goodbye, everybody! Goodbye, Bear! Goodbye forever!
Well, goodbye, Tutter. Gee, I'll miss seeing Tutter around the big blue house. I'll miss seeing his little blue ears wiggle and his little tail twitch and seeing his face light up when he says, cheese!
Oh, Bear! What was I thinking? I can't stay in here forever, no way! Gee whiz, that was the longest 5 seconds of my life! I mean, I like the way my mouse hole looks and everything, but I like to be out in the real world with my friends, best of all!
Aw, I'm so glad you're back, Tutter. Yeah? I'd really miss having a good friend like you around.
Bye, Bear.
Bye, Tutter. No matter how nice your things are, they're never as nice as the people or mice you care about. Now, here's something for you to look at. Here's a storybook about your adventure with Tutter. It's called
mouse hole beautiful. Tutter asked you for ideas on how to decorate his mouse hole. You mixed paints to create a whole new color. The picture you took in the kitchen was terrific. The light inside the trunk was perfect for a mouse's hole. Tutter loved all the things you found for his mouse hole.
Aha! Yes! Hey there! Back again? Great! I saw a bowl that would be perfect for making triple berry pie. And you know what? Your basket looks like the perfect place to keep it in. Here! I smell a pie in the making! If you want to, you can join me and we'll find the things to make triple berry pie! So, what do you want to do? All right, let's go to the otter pond!
Phew! I'm out of breath! How'd you get here so quickly? You're pretty fast!
Today is a perfect day for a picnic, don't you think? Ah, yes, we'll be outside. Smelling the flowers, the trees, and the honey the bees make. Hey, let's make it a special type of picnic, a pie picnic. We'll surprise all our friends.
I just know the sweet smell of triple berry pie will bring everyone from the big blue house out here to the pond.
One of the great things about triple berry pie is that every time you make it, you can add something different that makes it smell a little different. To make it smell sweet, we can add honey. Of course, strawberry jam is good too. So is applesauce. Well, what would you like? Spice is always nice. Spices like cinnamon or nutmeg or cloves make triple berry pie triple delicious. The best part is the topping. Ah, yes, like butterscotch, or there's always chocolate syrup, or even marshmallow cream around the house. Ah, yes, there sure are a lot of great choices. Now, since this is your special pie, you can help me find all the ingredients for it. When something is too hot to hold in your hands, I use a pot holder. I use this barrel to keep things in.
Don't tell Pip you saw me.
This hanging lamp lights my way. That way I don't trip on the stairs when I go up to see Luna at night. Huh? Ojo, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Bear.
I wonder if Ojo has something we need for the pie. To use a spice in cooking, you need to crush it up.
Pip is looking for me. Don't tell him I'm here. It'll be our secret.
Shh. I call my friends on the telephone. This is one of my favorite snacks. Sometimes I eat it under the stars, after talking to Luna. That picture on the easel smells interesting. Ooh, it smells sort of sweet, actually. Hey, wait a minute. That paint doesn't look like paint. It looks like...
Hey, Treelo, meet Piggy with fingers.
I can see that, Treelo, and it's a very nice painting. But... where did you get the paint?
The kitchen! Found it in the kitchen!
Treelo says he found the paint in the kitchen. Maybe you should take a closer look. Funny, that paint smells like... hey, that's not paint! It's chocolate syrup! You found our topping for the pie!
Oh, whoops! Sorry, dear! Treelo!
Oh, that's okay, Treelo. Your food painting is beautiful and smells great, too.
Oh, tastes good. But the beer finger kind of sticky. Treelo had to go wash hands. Bye!
Smells like honey. I had some for a snack last night and must have left it here. Mmm, what a sweet smell.
Looking for my spice garden? Why don't you try by my swing, where it's bright and sunny? I wonder if my herb and spice garden inside would have what we need. Brr, it's cold inside my fridge, but that way my string beans stay fresh and crunchy.
Some smells tickle your nose and make you sneeze. Did you know when you sneeze, you can't keep your eyes open? See?
Don't tell Pop you saw me.
Looking for my spice garden? Why don't you try by my swing, where it's bright and sunny? Big, plump, juicy berries taste so good, especially in my famous triple berry pancakes, and of course my triple berry pie.
Your basket holds lots. Just pick the room you want to visit, and you'll go right there.
Huh? Ojo, what are you doing?
Oh, hi there.
I wonder if Ojo has something we need for the pie. To use a spice in cooking, you need to crush it up. This bear loves to smell a big old bunch of fresh flowers.
At dinner, it's fun to close your eyes before you see your food and take a nice big sniff. Can you guess what's for dinner without peeking? Try it.
Huh? Ojo, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Bear.
I wonder if Ojo has something we need for the pie. To use a spice in cooking, you need to crush it up. Huh? Ojo, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Bear.
I wonder if Ojo has something we need for the pie.
Looking for my spice garden?
You need to
crush it up.
Why don't you try by my swing, where it's bright and sunny?
Like in this bowl?
Right. That's called a mortar. And the thing that looks like a long, thin stone is a pestle. Pick it up and use it to grind the spice into a powder.
Okay, the spice is all powdery now.
Use the spoon to scoop out the powder. Now take the powder and put it in the jar.
Look, now we have a jar of spice.
The smell of cinnamon makes me think of breakfast. I like to sprinkle it on toast.
Hey, you found everything to make triple berry pie. Now let's go to the kitchen and see what kind of pie maker you are.
Okay, ready to follow Bear's special recipe for triple berry pie? Listen carefully. The best thing for flattening pie dough is a rolling pin. A pie cutter is good for cutting the pie dough so it'll fit. Mixing the berries with the spice and sweetener gives the triple berry pie its special flavor. Put all three things in the bowl. Now that the berries and spice are mixed together, they can go into the pie pan on top of the dough. It's called a topping because it goes on top.
Add this on top and you'll be done.
Wow, what a great looking pie. You did such a good job. And now it's all ready to bake. The pie is still hot, so we'll leave it on the basket for it to cool. Then we can call the others. Hey! Before I forget, here's your final storybook.
This book tells the story of our adventure together. It's called Triple Berry Bear. You chose three favorite things to add to the triple berry pie. Treelo was using the topping to paint a picture. You found my leftover snack on the balcony, and it made the pie sweet. You and Ojo found just the right spice in my window garden. The pie you helped bake smelled delicious.
I can't wait to surprise everyone with our delicious pie. Can you? Let's see if the pie is cool enough to eat yet. The pie's gone! Hey, wait a minute. I don't see a pie, but I definitely smell it.
Wait a minute.
Hi, Bear. Really good triple berry pie.
Hi, Bear. How good.
Hey, Bear, we were just having...
a tiny little taste.
Yeah, just a little one. Mm. Hey, Bear, just eat a small mouse-sized piece, that's all.
you guys, I mean, when did you ate all of the pie?
Later, Bear.
Oh, gee, look at the time.
Oh, well, at least everybody really enjoyed the triple berry pie.
Surprise!
Here you go, Bear.
We really had you fooled, didn't we?
Yeah, we sure did.
You didn't really think that we'd eat all of your pie, did you?
You guys really got me that time. Hey, look. Here's a piece for you. Dig in. We've had a good time here in the big blue house. You make a wonderful triple berry pie, right?
Oh, yeah!
It was a feast for all five senses, and it looked delicious, too. And I bet if you used your imagination, you could taste how sweet it was, smell its wonderful smell, and feel the crunch in your mouth. Triple berry pie is so good, it makes you want to shout about it. I love triple berry pie! Go ahead, say it. Come on, guys.
We love triple berry pie!
Yeah.
Bye, Bear.
Later, Bear.
Oops, see you, Bear.
Bye-bye. Hey, you can stay longer if you like. There's lots to explore in the big blue house. Everyone's still around to play with. And you can even collect more berries and we'll make another pie. And don't forget, anytime you want to remember the fun you've had, you can open your storybooks. Hey, let's see what smells so good. Come on. Hey.
Hey.
Achoo! Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Great, let's go left. Great, let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Great, let's go left. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Okay, we'll go straight ahead. Hey, what's that smell? It reminds me of Ojo Island. It's a coconut. I love to break open the hard shell and eat the soft white coconut inside. Want to borrow my nose for another scent search? You found everything for the pie, except the berries. We'll need 6 bunches of berries. Have you seen any berries around?
There's lots to see in a house. You've got walls and a floor and a hole for a door. There's lots to see for a mouse. Things to look at galore you never noticed before. The one thing I can advise is use your eyes. See here, pull the shades up, turn the lights on. There's a world to set your sights on when you use your eyes. See here, see here. Keep keen eyes, stay in focus. Keep real close watch and notice. Who knows what you'll see here? Some tiny bugs that creep, some dust you forgot to sweep, all piled in a great big heap. Just let those peepers peep. See here, take a look at the world around you, and the world just might astound you when you see what you see here. You can watch the evening star. It's a light that shines from far. It comes right to where you are. Wow, what I see here when I let my eyes meander and have a look-see, take a gander, is my very favorite view. 'Cause what I see is you. When I open up my ears, a whole new world appears. I love to listen to the sounds everybody hears. Like a kitten that is purring, or a bus that's shifting gears. Listen. Open up your ears. Open up your ears. Can you hear what this bear hears? A dog is howling with a siren as it nears. There's caterwauls of alley cats, moos of cows and steers. Listen, open up your ears. When you open up your ears, it fills you full of cheers. Don't let a thunder crash bring you to tears. 'Cause the cozy sounds of raindrops will chase away your fears. Just listen, open up your ears. Open up your ears. Each day a song premieres. The birds sing and the bees hum as the sun appears. and crickets chirp a symphony when the evening clears. Listen, open up your ears, just listen, and open up your ears. Some people like clams in their chowder. Some people like lemons in tea. Some people like hot chili powder. Our tastes don't have to agree. We all have our favorite flavors, from oysters to minty toothpaste. And whether or not you like chili, that's chili or hot, you've got taste. You've got taste. You've got taste. Such good taste. And with one bite, with one chew, you just know, because you have taste. Some folks have a sweet tooth for jelly. It's right on the tip of their tongue. Some grown-ups like cheese that's real smelly. And baby food's good when you're young. So sour, sweet, salty, or bitter, you don't let good food go to waste. Whether you like it or hate it, or you never ate it before, you've got taste. Betcha a nickel and a dime, you can tell pickle from lime, because you've got really great taste. Everything you touch can tell you so much. It's all in the way that you feel. Close your eyes and you'll be surprised at how much your fingers reveal. Feel your blanket when you go to bed. It feels so warm and familiar. Hey, who's putting jelly on top of your head? Nothing on earth feels sillier. Everything you touch tells you so much. It's all in the way that you feel. Your teddy bear, or your grandmother's hair, or a squishy banana peel. Feel the ice cream soft and cold, wet and slippery, on your tongue tippery, melting in your mouth right away. It feels exactly like a summer day. Everything you touch can tell you so much, but you already know the whole deal. So go ahead, touch. It's all in the way that you feel. I smell berries, I smell honey, I smell morning bright and sunny. I smell a sudsy bubble bath, flowers lead me down a garden path. I smell leaves that someone's raking, and all along this walk I'm taking, wherever a new smell blows, I follow my nose. I follow my nose, follow my nose, when something's in the air. Whatever the smell, my nose can just tell. I follow and it leads me there. I smell lawns and power mowers, revving cars and the great outdoors. Smells and smells without an end. That one reminds me of a friend. Smell the country, smell the city. Smells can be strange or not too pretty, but some smell like a rose. And how do you suppose can tell these smells from those? You follow your nose. You follow your nose. You follow your nose. Just ask your nose. It knows.
Do you want to leave this game? Click yes or no. You can leave for now, visit Luna, and hear her sing the goodbye song. Visit Luna and hear her sing the goodbye song. Come on in! It's so good to see you again. Visit Luna and... Luna, would you sing the goodbye song with us before you go?
I would love to, Bear.
Hey, this was really fun.
We hope you liked it too.
Seems like we've just begun
when suddenly we're through.
Goodbye, goodbye, good friends, goodbye.
'Cause now it's time to go.
But hey, I say, well that's okay.
'Cause we'll see you very soon, I know.
Very soon, I know.
Goodbye, goodbye, good friends, goodbye.
Goodbye.
And tomorrow just like today. The moon, the bear, and the big blue house will be waiting for you to come and play. Come and play. Come and play.
Bye now.
Visit Luna and hear her sing the goodbye song. The credits tell you the names of all the people who helped bring you the big blue house today. Do you want to take a break? Thanks for coming to visit the Big Blue House. Come back again real soon.